Merrill Lynch is up 9/16. DLJ also higher by more than 2. And DLJ Direct also seeing a nice performance after the numbers, up a half a point to 15.625. Joining us now to discuss earnings and the future of both DLJ as well as DLJ Direct is Joe Roby, the Chief Executive Officer of Donaldson, Lufkin, and Jenrette. Mr. Roby, thank you so much for being with us.
Hi, Maria. Nice to see you again.
Congratulations on a great quarter.
Thanks.
What drove the earnings?
Well, I think from DLJ's perspective, we had very strong results in investment banking, which we were pleased about. In particular, our M&A group had a great quarter, the best quarter we've had in the M&A business in our history. M&A revenues were just short of $600 million for the 9 months. That's up from about $400 million for the comparable period a year ago. So that was a very strong driver for us.
We certainly have seen a number of big deals on Wall Street, and I see that DLJ was a big participant in that. Now, do you think that continues going out, say, 6 to 9 months out? And what about international? I know that you made some comments earlier on the wires as far as the possible expansion of M&A activities abroad.
Well, we continue to build out our European Investment Banking Group, which is very critical to our M&A success going forward. In terms of backlog, we have pretty strong backlogs in the M&A business in the fourth quarter and going into the first quarter of next year. Beyond that, I'd have to say my crystal ball is a little bit cloudy.
Okay, well, fair enough. I wanted to talk a bit about DLJ and DLJ Direct. In fact, you did issue a tracking stock for DLJ Direct on May 26th, I believe, priced at $20 a share. But interestingly, not only DLJ Direct stock has moved lower, but DLJ stock has also moved lower. I know that we have a chart to actually bring up. DLJ Direct is down about 48%. From the time that the tracking stock came out. Why do you think that is?
Well, I think trading activity slowed down some in the third quarter. For whatever reason, the analysts that cover that industry, I think, were not quite prepared for the fact that trading activities in our industry, including the online business, are cyclical and also have a seasonal pattern. So that took people a little bit by surprise. But basically, fundamentally, DLJ Direct had a terrific third quarter, down slightly from the second quarter, and is off to a good start in the fourth quarter.
What about DLJ stock? Do you think there was some disappointment out there that perhaps you guys did a tracking stock as opposed to an out-and-out IPO? Perhaps that's the reason why DLJ itself is down about 35% since DLJ Direct came to market.
I don't think that had much impact, Maria, although some people would make that argument. I think overall the securities industry stocks have gone through a period of adjustment after some strong gains earlier in the year, and we've been the victim of a little bit of that adjustment.
Sure, and the adjustment, of course, extends throughout the industry. How do you deal with that, Mr. Roby? I mean, you see sell-offs in the stock prices, say, Merrill Lynch, when Merrill decided to offer online trading. How do you deal with sort of both contingencies, the individual online as well as the institutional client out there charging higher fees?
Well, I think it's important to do what is fundamentally best for the business, which is what we're all about in both our individual and our retail and our online businesses. In each case, we try to posture our products and services which serves the needs of that customer base best, and that's what we're all about. We kind of ignore the short-term fluctuations in stock prices.
Probably a good idea. Your biggest opportunity going forward?
I think there's lots of room for DLJ to grow here. We've been focused for some years on getting our business up to the $5 billion net revenue level. We've got a good shot at doing that this year with $3.9 billion in the first 9 months. So that's an important milestone for us. We've got lots of room for growth in international markets where we're a relative latecomer, but making some great progress. So we're extremely optimistic about our business.
Mr. Roby, we wish you the best of luck.
Thanks, Maria.
Thanks so much for being with us.
Take care.
The CEO of DLJ, Joe Roby, joined us today live from his firm's office.